Good evening, everyone. My name is Tennille Moulton. I'm the director here at the Orange Mound Senior Center. It's really Orange Mound Community Service Center, but we call it the Senior Center, where we service ages 50 and up. We are about fun, fitness, and fellowship here. So I'm going to take you on a little tour of what some things that we do. The building is 33,000 square feet. And we have a banquet room, arts and crafts, library, fitness room, the gym, dance studio, just a plethora of activities for seniors. Now, if you want to talk about fun for ages 50 and up, we have checkers and spade players, and over here to the left is our pool room. Okay, and then we have people playing checkers.
Tell me a little bit about the importance of the Orange Mound Senior Community Center.
The importance of the Orange Mound Community Center, Senior Center, is a place that they can come throughout the week to keep from being at home. Mainly everyone is pretty much retired, some are even still working, but it's a place where they can get out and be safe and just fellowship and have fun with their friends.
How many people do you see come through the center every day?
On an average, we have about 250 to 300 members that come in. We have maybe 1,300 plus members on our roster.
Okay.
And they're playing cards here, spades.
Hey, everybody. So, as you get to know people, how does that affect your relationships in the community overall?
Well, getting to know them, by me not being from this area, it was important to establish a relationship with them and let them know that I'm here for their to support them and to be just a resource for them to get different avenues of activities and funding and things of that nature. But it's very important to establish a relationship because this is a population where it's very sensitive and people tend to try to take advantage of seniors. So I let them know that I'm here to help them. Well, right now we're going to the gym. This is where we hold our aerobics class in the morning time. There may be some free play going on right now, it may not, but just imagine this gym full of seniors on a daily basis, every day.
And how many people come to the aerobics class?
We have about 75 to 100 people in the aerobics class.
Oh, wow.
So this is the gym. And right now there's no activities. Usually there's like an after school program and school's still in, so we're just kind of silent over here now. But we also today we have Mr. Trent here.
He is
signing up people to register to vote.
That is correct. So. All right then, are you a registered voter?
I am a registered voter.
Very good, very good. Well, if you know of anyone who would like to register to vote, I'm here.
What days are you here?
Today until 4.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
So we'll go back on the other side. Thank you, Mr. Trent.
You're welcome. Take care now.
Tell me about some of the daily activities that you have and some of the people that you get to meet from working in the center.
Oh, I've met retired teachers, lawyers, physicians, just a plethora of people in the Orange Mound community itself. Some very dignified seniors. They take pride in their community. They take pride in the center. We're nationwide. I have members that are not even from Orange Mound. I have members who come from Mississippi, Arkansas. I even have a member that's lives in Arizona, and she visits here frequently, and she loves this place. That's just the name of it. So we're nationwide. They just love this town, and I love it as well. But some of the activities we have are senior aerobics, line dance, which we are the house for the Energizers.
Mm-hmm.
We put on performances all over the city. We have Tai Chi. We have yoga classes. We have Sit and Be Fit for our disabled who are can't walk or who are limited. They can sit in a chair and exercise. I can show you the banquet room.
You also said that you all work with MIFA sometimes?
Yes, MIFA, we do MIFA meals, Meals on Wheels. So we have about 45 recipients. MIFA recipients have to be 62 or older, and they eat their lunch in here in the morning time. Over there is our drama team. They're practicing for a performance that they have coming up here soon, well, for the holidays. So we're excited about getting to hear them and see them.
Oh, when is the performance?
It's in December.
I'd like to talk to you about a job.
Who do you think I am? One of the Kelly girls?
Wait a minute. I'll do anything for it.
Well, yeah.
I need $10 to buy a Christmas present for my mother and father. And it's only 2 days before Christmas.
So they're practicing for a Christmas play that they're doing. Right now we also have Senior Olympics going on throughout the city. It's over 25 different events. Here at Orange Mound, we are known for the shuffleboard event and the hot shot event.
What do you mean?
A hot shot is a around the world, they call it basketball around the world. And shuffleboard is, it's a board game where you have a puck and a stick and you shoot it to the other side and you get points that way. But it's very popular and with seniors, they love shuffleboard.
Everyone in Orange Mound seems to be really history oriented and they seem to really take a lot of pride in the community. Do you see symbols of that pride sometimes in the center?
Oh yes, definitely. They get a bit competitive with one another as far as different activities and wanting to represent for their particular activity and for the community as well. And these are some murals of some past history and present things that have been going on in Orange Mound. It started with just a meeting that the author told them to bring some clippings and things from different areas of Orange Mound. And he was going to put them together to do a collage, and that's what he came up with.
Okay. So you talked about the fun part of the Senior Center. Tell me a little bit more about the fitness activities.
Okay, some of our fitness activities. Again, we have senior aerobics that is usually goes on in the gym in the morning time. And we have about 75 to 100 seniors in there. But we also have a fitness center, and I'll show you where the fitness center is. But we also have Energizers, line dancing, we have Sit and Be Fit, Tai Chi, yoga, and I think I said Sit and Be Fit. But this is our fitness room right here.
Yeah.
Where we have state-of-the-art equipment for our seniors. And they come in and work out and they fellowship. So that's some of the fitness and the fellowship part about it. It's just seniors having a place to go and to be amongst their peers.
Mm-hmm.
We also have a Bible study on Wednesdays. So for some of the more religious ones, they can do Bible study. And here is our arts and crafts studio, where we have, these are some of the things that seniors make. Ceramics, they knit, crochet, they do a little sewing. And they also have their projects for sale.
And our studio instructor just walked in, Ms. Pat Malone.
This is the crafts room, and we basically work with four crafts: crocheting, knitting, quilting, and ceramics. I usually have anywhere with the combined classes, because some of the ladies do more than one craft, but generally I have about 30, 35 people if everybody came at the same time. But the ladies come in and they work at their leisure, because many of them are involved in other activities in the center. We have so much going on here that it's kind of hard to stick to one thing. But we have a lot that come to crafts. They may go to the choir, to computer, to line dancing, to the drama club, what have you. On this table, these two tables here and back on the back wall, these are some of the items that the crafts has made, that they sell. I always say the city gives us a place to work, but they don't give us anything to work with. You see before you on this side of the room, at one point I had about 18 ceramic students. Don't have as many now because we lost three of our people over a period of time. They passed away, and then we've had some to move out of the city, etc. But you can see some of the projects that they've done, and I would like to think that they enjoy what they're doing. I know I love it, and they can come and work some of the things they can work on at home. But we try to teach them, I guess I try to impart to them the love that I have for working with my hands. And we have several ladies who have come in and they've said, I'm too old, I can't learn a new skill. And I always say, well, let's try. And what helps me and what brightens my day is when they look at something that they have made with their hands, and the smile that comes over their faces, and that really makes me feel good as well.
Ms. Pat, are you from Orange Mound?
No, I'm originally from Chattanooga, Tennessee, but I've been in Memphis for over 50 years. I married a gentleman from Memphis, and that's how I got here. I never lived in Orange Mound, but I know and have many, many friends in the Orange Mound area. My husband was from Orange Mound. He attended Melrose High School. He and his brother and his sister, there were three of them. And
why do you think that activities like this are important to the senior center?
Oh, definitely. Seniors, sometimes people will come and they'll come in and they say, I've retired, but I'm not doing anything but sitting at home. And of course, there are those who have always wanted to learn. They come in and say, oh, I've always wanted to learn to crochet, or I've always wanted to learn how to quilt. My grandmother quilted. And, you know, that kind of thing. And of course, it's sedentary because we're sitting down and we're not being active, but many of our ladies, they come, they go to the aerobics class, or they're in the line dancing class, or even in the sit and fit activities. And so they try to, you know, to compensate there. But I think that, like I said, it's a joy to me to see them when they have finished a product and they look at it and the smile that comes over their face, you know, to realize that they have actually done something like this.
All right. Thank you so much. We appreciate you today.
All right.